Coming up on this edition of EuroPass, we visit a vineyard near Vicenza, Italy, to discover how fine Italian wines are made. We'll also find out the Vicenza area has a lot to offer in the way of outdoor activities and cultural points of interest. All of this and more, next on EuroPass. And welcome to EuroPass. I'm Angela West. Italy is well known throughout the world for its fine wines. Service members stationed in Vicenza, Italy, live in one of the world's most renowned regions for wines, the Veneto. Tonight, we're headed to a typical vineyard near Vicenza where the annual grape harvest is coming in. There, we'll introduce you to a family that's been making fine wines for generations. And we'll learn firsthand how wine is made from vine to bottle.
Vicenza lies in the Veneto region of northern Italy, nestled at the base of the Dolomite Mountains and surrounded by a landscape dotted with picturesque vineyards, seemingly as far as the eye can see. It's believed that in and around Vicenza, with its temperate climate and fertile hilly surroundings, grapes have been cultivated since the Bronze Age.
Wine is definitely part of the Italian culture. As you probably know, Italian cuisine is known all over the world, and wine is a very fundamental part of the Italian cuisine. A glass of wine is something that is ingrained in the local culture. It doesn't really matter what wine you're serving, as long as it's good, it's fresh, and it's shared by families and friends.
Wine experts and connoisseurs regard the Veneto among the leading wine-producing regions in Italy, both for quality and quantity. Many of the Veneto's wines are internationally known and appreciated. One vineyard not far from Vicenza that's typical of the region is Moraro's. The Moraro family has been working the land and making local wines here for generations.
Papà che ha cominciato una quarantina d'anni fa ormai che l'azienda va avanti. Noi figli di Luigi siamo qua da quando siamo bambini che lavoriamo qua in azienda, insomma. Noi giovani abbiamo cercato di fare del nostro meglio per ingrandirla, per renderla più funzionale, più moderna. Adesso siamo i tre fratelli, sempre col papà che supervisiona tutto quanto e ecco, andiamo avanti nel modo migliore l'attività.
Visiting Moraro's during harvest season, you can learn how their wines are made from vine to bottle.
La storia del vino in pratica è semplicissimo. C'è la vigna, c'è l'uva, è una cosa veramente più che naturale, che non si fa altro che fare qualcosa che sennò verrebbe in natura. Cerca di controllarlo, quindi dall'uva si porta su delle diraspatrici dove viene tolto il raspo, la parte interna, rimangono proprio gli acini, la polpa, il succo, viene messo sulle grandissime presse, dei torchi proprio delle presse, che dove viene schiacciato, si estrae proprio la parte, il succo vero e proprio, ok? Si mette su delle grandi cisterne, ok? Del big bottle, delle grandi cisterne, dove il vino piano piano nel tempo si limpidisce, diventa bello, puro. Deposita la parte, la polpa come viene tolta, rimane proprio il vino bello limpido, poi si lascia un po' maturare nelle vasche un paio di mesi, due o tre mesi così, e poi viene messo o nelle cisterne direttamente per la vendita al minuto, sulle damigiane, sulle taniche, oppure viene imbottigliato a seconda della qualità, la qualità superiore, di miglior gradazione così viene imbottigliata e il resto viene venduto come vino scuro qua in azienda.
Whether you're a wine connoisseur and enthusiast, want to learn more about how wines are made, or just interested in finding an inexpensive bottle that you can enjoy with a nice meal, the wineries and vineyards of the Veneto are waiting for you.
Dico che molti americani vengono qua perché hanno la possibilità, oltre che di vedere proprio la cantina, le vasche grandi, il vino direttamente sui loro contenitori originali, hanno la possibilità di taste, loro dicono, di assaggiare questo, un altro, e poi le varietà sono tante. qui hanno un'ottima scelta e allora vengono qua volentieri. Poi vedono anche I prezzi, dicono, ma sembra quasi impossibile che in America una bottiglia di vino $20 e more, no? Invece qua da noi con 2-3 euro si beve benissimo e si ha tutto quanto alla portata di mano.
A beautiful region. Definitely the perfect destination for wine lovers. But there's more to Vicenza than just vineyards and vino.
The cobbled streets of the city center are lined with quaint cafes, shops, and architectural gems designed by the world-famous architect Andrea Palladio, like Teatro Olimpico, the oldest indoor theater in the Western world. The stage resembles a facade of a Renaissance palace. The proscenium is decorated with sculpture and relief and numerous statues placed in and above the arches. Illusionistic street vistas can be seen through the central arch of the stage and side doorways radiating in five directions. This introduced the idea of perspective in modern theater. One of the best ways to get out and see the city or the beautiful countryside is on a bicycle. Find out about tours offered in the Veneto region of wineries or other tours, log on to the Vicenza Information Tours and Registration website at vicenzamwr.com and follow the link to ITR. Or check with your local MWR office to find out about ways to discover the areas near you just waiting to be explored.
That wraps up our show for this week. We'd like to thank the Moraro family, the Vicenza Education Center, and Vicenza MWR's Outdoor Recreation. If you have a place you'd like to see us visit, or a program you'd like to know more about, send us an email at europass@smc.army.mil. For more travel ideas, don't forget to pick up the Thursday edition of Stars and Stripes, and check out the travel section. To see this program again, log on to our website at afneurope.net. I'm Angela West, and we'll see you next time on EuroPass.